Suppose I'm very lonely. Lonely, though I'm married, children, go to the office, go to the temple, and all that nonsense that goes on. I'm utterly, profoundly lonely. And being lonely, I escape, because I don't know how to tackle that loneliness. I don't understand what loneliness is, but I'm frightened. This sense of utter existence for a day, month, in which there is no relationship with another, no sense of communication with another. Thoroughly enclosed. Don't you know all these feelings? Wake up. And as my brain doesn't know how to solve it, then escapes through entertainment, right? Whether it's religious entertainment or football, they are both the same. You agree? Huh? Are you really agreeing to this? That religious entertainment, going to the temple, the puja and all that thing that goes on there, which is an entertainment, but that doesn't alter your life, just a amusement. And football are the same. Do you agree to this? Huh? Is it mental agreement? Just a verbal agreement, or an actual saying this is the same, therefore finish with it? So what is loneliness? You understand? Without escaping, without running away from into some illusory, imaginary ideal, the actual fact is that I am despairingly, anxiously lonely. I may be married, I may have sex, I may have children, but this thing is rotting. Like a man who is deeply hurt, as most of us are, from childhood we are hurt, and he catches that hurt throughout life. And you can say, it doesn't matter, it will not affect my action. But it does affect your action, because unconsciously, deeply, your actions are guided by your hurt. You build a wall around yourself not to be hurt more, and all that business goes on. The consequences of that hurt is bitterness, more loneliness. And this loneliness, why do human beings go through this? You ask yourself, right, as two friends we are talking about, why? It must exist because of your actions. Right? Go into it, don't agree. Your daily actions are self-centered. Right? Your daily thoughts, your daily activities are concerned with yourself. You may pretend to be a social worker and give your life to that, but the me is still going on. Only you have identified yourself with something. Like the communist identifies with the state, with the ideal, with blah blah. you identify yourself with something else. So, as long as there is self-centered activity, there must be loneliness. I don't know if you see this. If your chief concern is me, then that me must act in a very narrow circle, however that circle may be wide or deep, but it's a narrow circle. And that action must inevitably produce this exhausting, despairing loneliness.